Hi everyone. Microsoft Loop is a prominent product in Microsoft 365, and Microsoft is investing always more resources to bring more capabilities. There is still a lot to do from my point of view, but in this video I would like to introduce a new preview feature that allows users to upload files in Microsoft Loop workspaces. This is very useful if you want to connect files with Loop pages. All right, let me walk you through this new feature. Let's go. Here I have Microsoft Loop open. I have loop.cloud.microsoft in the browser open. As you can see here, I have the preview of Microsoft Loop. I made another video how you can turn on preview features in Microsoft Loop and get the latest and greatest capabilities. So let's focus on workspaces here. So let me open this workspace that I have, Project Brown X. In this sample, I have, as you can see, this workspace shared with four members. I have other colleagues that have access to this workspace. Now, what I would like to do here in the project planning page, I would like to connect some files that I created for this project. Now, how I can upload files in Loop. So when you click now, when you are on a workspace and when you click on the Create New button, you will notice a new option available here called Upload a File. So I can target one or multiple files. So let me open these two, for example, Copilot and M365 Chicago Community Days. Now these two files are getting uploaded, and these two files are dropped in your personal OneDrive. So it means that a new folder will be generated there, but we will see in a bit. So now I have on top of every page the link to these two files. Now let's say that I want to create a visual connection between the file and the page. In this case, I'm going to drag and drop this file on the page which should be related on. So now I have these two files under the project planning, and visually I have the feeling that these two files are connected to this page. All right, now of course what I can do is, or alternatively what I can do is copying this file and paste the link of this file. And now I can open, of course, this is the preview of the file, and now I can open this presentation if I want. All right, let's see now what happens with other members that have access to the workspace. So first of all, let me open OneDrive. And to do that, I'm going to open another page that I have here. And then I'm going to right click on this one and I open my OneDrive space in another tab. Now let's open my files. And here on top, I have a new folder just created about a minute ago. It's called Loop. Now clicking on this folder, I can see that there is another folder called Workspace Uploads. Clicking on this one, I can see the two files that I uploaded before in the workspace. So let me show you something here. If I right click on this first file and if I click on Manage Access, I am the only one that has access to this file. And how this is possible if the workspace is shared with other members? So now let me show you another thing. Opening the same page, so getting access to loop.microsoft.com, which will become loop.cloud.microsoft. I'm opening now Microsoft Loop with a different perspective. I am at the events now, and what I can see here, I am on production. Let me switch to the preview so I can refresh the page. Now I can see that this is the preview of Microsoft Loop. Let me get in the workspace where I have access. And if I expand now the page project planning, I can see that there are two files, the two files just uploaded. Now I see the link, but Adele Events has no access. What happens if I click on a file? So basically, a new permission will be granted to Adele Events. Now Adele Events is opening the file. And in fact, if I go again on the OneDrive of Giuliano, and if I click, right click again and manage access on this file, a new permission has been granted to Adele Events, because Adele Events is member of the workspace, so the file is uploaded on the workspace where Adele Events has access on, and it's naturally understandable the fact that she will have access also to the files connected to the workspace. This will happen automatically. Now, something to keep in mind is that if you delete a file, so let me delete this one, the file will be not deleted automatically in OneDrive. So this is something that I recognize it playing with this new feature. So it is deleted only the link in Microsoft Loop, but not the file. In fact, if I reopen OneDrive and if I refresh the same page, the file is still there. So you need to clean up by yourself this thing. I hope that this thing will change in the future, maybe with an option here when the user click delete the link or delete the link and the file. So this will help the user to keep cleaned their OneDrive space. Similarly, if I reopen OneDrive and if I delete manually a file that is connected to a Loop workspace, let's see what is gonna happen. So now I have the file listed here. If I refresh the page, I will still see this link. But when I click on the link, of course, the file is no longer there, stored on OneDrive, so I will get an error message coming from SharePoint. Here there is the announcement by Microsoft, which highlight some facts very important. For example, you cannot exceed, a file cannot exceed 250 giga in size. You can upload multiple files at a time, and every file will be stored in OneDrive for Business, as we mentioned it. Here there is also an important paragraph if you want to start to play with this feature, which I remember you is in preview. Here you can read something if this feature doesn't show up in your preview version of Microsoft Loop. And you can upload Word, PowerPoint, Excel, and PDF file. We have seen a new feature in preview in Microsoft Loop that allows to upload files. Do you like it? Let me know in the comment. Add a like if you enjoyed this video, and please consider to subscribe. I hope to see you next time. Bye.